I want to provide a little bit of clarification as to where you should host your WordPress website. And more specifically, I wanted to talk about WordPress.com. So when we think about WordPress, a lot of people think, well, it's WordPress.com. But that is not really WordPress. That is a place to host your WordPress website. It's just a hosting company. But it's a hosting company owned by WordPress itself, okay? Now, when people are talking about WordPress, they're usually talking about wordpress.org. That's the website URL. And now, it's important to note that these are two separate things. WordPress.org is where you actually get the program, the software, WordPress, to install on your web hosting account. WordPress.com is a where you would host your WordPress website, but see, there's a big drawback and a big negative in hosting your website at WordPress.com. A lot of people don't know this, but WordPress on WordPress.com is a modified version of WordPress, and what the negative is for you if you're going to host your WordPress site there, the negative is they strip away a lot of the features and the functionality and the options to change and customize things. They strip all those away from you when you have your website hosted on WordPress.com. And I actually see it a lot on this YouTube channel. I have people say, hey, you showed me how to do this and I had to click on this thing called the editor, but I don't have the editor. And the reason why you don't have that editor is because you're on WordPress.com. It's a very optimized, locked down version of WordPress. Now, people don't realize there's actually two versions of WordPress. There's the self-hosted installed version of WordPress you would put on your web hosting account. And there's something else called WordPress MU. And the MU stands for multiple users. And it's kind of technical what that is. But what you want to know is that you don't want your website, your WordPress site on WordPress MU in a WordPress MU network. And that's what WordPress.com is. And you just don't have the options to install whatever plugin or whatever theme you want. You don't get those options. You're pretty much stuck with whatever they let you have. And there's a technical reason why they do this, but it's not something that's going to really be a good thing for you. And on top of it, let's look at the cost of WordPress.com. So they don't show you when you come here what the costs are. Like I was scrolling down. Actually, it's right here, premium plans. Actually, it doesn't let you click on it. It doesn't let you click on the premium plans. I guess they want you to click on create a website and get further along in the process to actually show you what the cost is. But I found their pricing page. It's at wordpress.com/pricing. And the way I found it was I Googled wordpress.com pricing just so I could show you in this video. Now, when you go there, it looks like you're getting a free website, and you actually are, and they're very generous in doing that, but they don't let you have a custom domain name. So it'll be whatever.wordpress.com. So mynewtravelblog.wordpress.com. So you have this crazy long URL. It's not a custom URL. And that's what you get here with this free plan. And here's some of the highlights of it. Now the next bump up is $99 a year or $825 per month. It's actually, that's what it averages out to be, $825 per month, $100 a year. And then this will allow you to have right here this custom domain name. There's just some other things here as well. And then they have the next plan up, which is $25 per month billed yearly. The big benefit here is they give you access to themes that they've created. So this is what the crippled version of WordPress that you get on WordPress.com gives you. Now, I want to strongly urge you, if you're on WordPress.com, to get off. Or if you're thinking of getting a hosting account, to not go with WordPress.com. I'm going to suggest that you go with InMotion Hosting. I've got a link down below. And actually, when you go to InMotion through my link and make a or purchase a web hosting account, I just go ahead and send your receipt over to me. And I have a bonus package that includes some of my best training programs on WordPress covering SEO and all that. But that's not what this video is about. You can go to InMotion Hosting. Now, remember we were just on WordPress and we saw the cost per month? Well, when you visit my link to InMotion, you're going to get an immediate 38% off. And scroll down and look at these prices. They've got three plans. The cheapest is $489 per month, and then $629 per month, and $1049 per month. I personally use InMotion. My website is on InMotion. I have the Pro plan, and you can see the Pro plan, the best plan that they have, is still $15 per month less than WordPress's best plan. Their middle plan is $2 less and a lot more powerful, mind you, than the WordPress.com plan. And then you also have this baby plan here. Now, there's a lot of benefits to having it here. First of all, there's no restrictions on your WordPress site, the plugins and themes that you can install, and the customizations that you may want to make. You have no restriction on any of that. Okay, that's the first benefit. And their network that InMotion has is top-notch. Your website will be on what's called a solid-state drive, which is the same kind of storage used in your iPhones and iPads and tablets and things like that. It's lightning fast. InMotion has phenomenal support staff that is available via live chat to assist you whenever you may need any help with anything. And you're just going to have no restrictions going with a company like this. InMotion blows away the different hosting competition that's out there as well. I would strongly urge you to stay away from GoDaddy's hosting. I would strongly urge you to stay away from HostGator's hosting. And any of the companies owned by the parent company of HostGator, they own probably about 50 different hosting companies. So you're really dealing with the same company, and that goes for Bluehost as well. And the reason you want to avoid them is because your website is going to load very slow. That's the first reason, okay? You're going to have a very slow website. The time it takes to actually load the website. That's number one. Number two, they don't have the greatest support. You're not going to have the same speed to get help of support. Their infrastructure is older and outdated, and they seem to have significant hacking problems. So a good example is Bluehost. Bluehost websites, even though you're doing everything right, they don't have the security in place, so the websites get hacked, and then you get an email saying your website's down, you've got to fix it if you want it to go back up, or you can pay us $300 to fix it. You can Google that. There's a ton of stories about that right now on the internet of this kind of scheme from HostGator and Bluehost where they're letting your sites get hacked because of their bad infrastructure, and then they stick you with the bill. You don't get any of that with InMotion. They do backups for you, which is something you really don't get anywhere else. They're backing things up for you, and that's just one less thing that you have to worry about. So anyways, this video wasn't about InMotion per se. It was more about the recommendation to not host your website with WordPress.com. I love WordPress. I love everything about WordPress, but I don't love WordPress.com. The main thing I wanted to show you, here's WordPress.com and here's WordPress.org where you can download WordPress, but you don't even actually have to download it if you get InMotion. They have an installer built in that will install it for you with a click of a button. It's so easy. So if you do get a hosting with InMotion, make sure you number one, click through my link to get to their site so you can get that discount. But number two, After you've placed your order, go ahead and forward the receipt on to me. You can go to my website. There's a contact form. Send me that receipt number. I'll make sure you purchased it when you clicked on my link, and you will get access to all of the training programs that I sell on my website. Well, that's it for today's video. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it in the comment section down below. Please also give me a thumbs up on YouTube. That really helps me out. And if you haven't subscribed yet to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. That also helps me out. Now, I don't want you to ever leave empty-handed, and that's why I've put together a free video course just for my subscribers called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success. Now, if you would like free access to that course, just go ahead and click right here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.